think that it's really unfortunate in the position that he's in, having all of the resources that he has and the ability to have a much more educated opinion that he just hasn't. And then dragged all these other people in it by tagging them in it, obviously, and speaking about it at a time when, you know, the tournament was going on and all that we saw with the lack of investment, with the lack of resources, with the lack of funding. Like, that's just really frustrating that's the take that you have. You, like, you know, obviously you kind of showed your whole ass in not even talking, you know, not even understanding what we all talk about all the time, whether it's WNBA players or you know, us here on the national team. So that was frustrating. And also, like what Sue said, you tagged the wrong people. You don't think that we've asked for more money? I mean, what are we screaming about nonstop? If we're getting obnoxious to ourselves, to be honest. So it's just like, you have, you know, and then to obviously, you know, 2 or 3 days later, completely double down on it. Mm-hmm. Just, you know, it is really frustrating. And I think we know this about all social movements and all people who are marginalized, whether it's by race or gender or, you know, religion, sexuality, whatever it is not just their job to be the ones fighting oppression. We need all of the other people as well. So to have someone who does know what it's like to be oppressed in many ways, to heap that all back on, you know, female players or people who play female sports, it's just really disappointing. He has all the resources in the world. There's obviously a lot of amazing people that I know personally that work in the Warriors organization, who I'm sure are very happy to sit down with him. And any of us really would be happy to sit down with him. So hopefully that education process comes, because that was really disappointing. And from someone who has such a big platform, as we know, that's just not acceptable at all.